Welcome to Selenium Master Test Automation Crash Course, Selenium Python WebDriver, Lesson 15, Python WebDriver and jQuery UI Test Automation, Section Drag Drop Element. In this lesson, I will teach you how to test drag and drop actions using Selenium Python WebDriver. Now let's open the test site. I opened the jQueryUI.com/droppable for testing. On this web page, you will see two elements. One is drag me to my target. Second is drop here. So we can drag the element and drop into the frame or drop into the drop here element. Now the element is dropped in this window. When using Selenium Python WebDriver, we can test drag and drop actions. Now let's look at the HTML source of these elements and find out how these elements can be located. So I right-click on the drag me to my target element. Click on the inspect. Now, this element is within the iframe. Under this iframe, we can identify the draggable element using XPath div id attribute equals draggable. And we can identify the element drop here using div attribute id equals droppable. In the final assertion, we can compare the x position of the element draggable and droppable. When we drag the element and drop onto the section drop here, the element drag me is within this window. So the X position of the drag me element is greater than the X position of the drop here element. Since the elements are located within the iframe, we need to use switch to frame actions. Now let's look at the script. I open the Selenium Python WebDriver project and created a Python file drag_drop.py under the folder jQuery_UI. In this Python file, I used Python unit test framework. So import unit test, import time from Selenium, import WebDriver from selenium.webdriver.common.actionChains, import action chains. We need to use action chains module to achieve drag and drop actions. I defined a class named drag drop tests, and this class extends unit test.testcase module. On the setup method, def setup self, I define a driver instance for the Chrome. So self.driver equals webdriver.chrome. Then self.driver.maximizeWindow. This is to maximize the browser window. Now I define a test method, def test underscore action chains underscore drag underscore drop self. Now define a driver equals self.driver. Now navigate to the demo website, driver.get https://jQueryUI.com/droppable. Time.sleep 3 seconds. Now I define the frame. Frame equals driver.findElementByTagName. In the HTML source, we only have one iframe, so we can identify the element or frame using the tag name iframe. Now we need to switch the driver to the frame. So driver.switchTo.frame, and this is the frame we defined in this line. Now we define draggable element. Draggable underscore element equals driver.findElementByXPath parentheses double quote /div id attribute equals draggable. Now we define droppable element. So droppable underscore element equals driver.findElementByXPath div id attribute equals droppable. Now we define action chains. So actions equal action chains driver. So this is how you can use action chains. Now actions dot drag and drop. So when you define actions, you just type actions, then dot, you can find many actions. Let's say click and hold, context click, double click, drag and drop, drag and drop by offset, key down, key up. So you can use any of these actions from the list. So here I used the action drag and drop. So this is a draggable element and this is a droppable element, because we drag the element and drop into the droppable element. Now, once we define the actions, we need to perform the action. So actions.perform, then time.sleep 5 seconds. Now we need to use the X location for the assertion. So get draggable location. Now draggable location equals draggable element dot location. The dot location method we will return. You can do location. This method will return X and Y position as a dictionary. So now we print draggable position and draggable location. Now we get X position using the key X. So drag X equals draggable underscore location dot get X. Now we print drag X. Now we get the droppable element location. Droppable underscore location equals droppable underscore element dot location. Use print droppable position. And this is a droppable location. Now we get x position of droppable element. So drop underscore x equals droppable underscore location dot get x. Now we print drop x. Now we verify that drag x is greater than drop x, because we dragged the draggable element and dropped it within the droppable element. In other words, draggable element is within the droppable element after dragging and dropping. Now self dot assert true, drag x greater than drop x. Now on the teardown method, self.driver.close, self.driver.quit. So this main entry is optional. If you want to run the script outside of the PyCharm, you can define main entry for this Python script and call unittest.main. So now let's execute the script. Right click, run unit test action chains, drag and drop. So click on this button. Now the Chrome browser launched, maximized. It navigated to the testing. Now the element got dragged and dropped into the target. And on the console output, we see that the x value of the draggable element after getting dragged is 171 and droppable element is 146. So basically 171 is greater than 146. And this is the assertion. The test passed. So in summary, you need to define actions equal action chains driver, and then you call drag and drop action, then you call the perform method to perform.